work together with different organizations in the city, organizations representing other religions. We have the Muslim community organizations who have cooperated. We have come together to celebrate this week-long Interfaith Harmony Week.
The Zamboanga City Medical Center is fully convinced of the effort of Silsilah Dialogue Movement in fostering peace and harmony in the world, in Zamboanga, in the world, through Muslim-Christian dialogue. That is why during the World Interfaith Harmony Week, we offer our services like the bloodletting and milkletting to the community. And also we invite the youth to show love and compassion to our patients at the psychiatric ward and the pediatric wards, for them also to see how is it to be with the sick in a hospital setting.
One of the major problems is in the world is distributed. People don't know each other and they hate each other. So how can we overcome this? With this kind of programs, if we gather in the same place, that is the time we can get to know each other. Because up to this time, we didn't know each other. Maybe most of you, but now we know each other. So it's like making relationships. So having some friends. So this is the main purpose of this program. So hopefully we will do this every year outside.
Maraming salamat po sa Silsilah Foundation na kaming mga tricycle driver binigyan ng pagkakataon na magtipon-tipon sa ganitong klaseng event, tricycle forum, upang ipahayag namin kung ano man ang kasalukuban namin at ano yung mga puna sa mga tao para sa amin na hindi lang mga ehemplo na hindi maganda kung hindi para kabutihan din para sa amin.
Rindio gracias na silsila, no? Con este cosa sila taas eh, since yakita kami ki miembro 2013, no? Since 2013, at least siya pwede kita akwa ng mga operators, ng mga driver, na nisisita kita man start LPs, na igual el din yung mensahe del 2015, no? It is like a chain na we have to start from ourselves, no? Kaba, aliba kita na pasahero, el quedan buenamente, pati este between el government, el silsila, and work each other together con el mga presidente del asociacion. Bien grande gaste ayuda. At least kasi kita kanila importante, na insinya kita kanila na hindi lang na tourism, na inner di ila. no, ta insinya kita kanila. And thank you very much, Silsilah, for this project.
What we can do more to make a better world? When we came with this idea that World Interfaith Harmony Week, there is a certain spirit that we in Silsilah were happy to listen, the spirit to start something new, an initiative based on the love of God and the love of neighbor and the love of common good.
Again, everybody can come together at bitbisig mag-volunteer para sa mga pagkakatawag na ganito para gumawa ng mabuti para magkaroon ng mapayapang lugar.
To the celebration of the World Interfaith Harmony Week, so it is important na we leaders from the different barangays come together to listen and to discuss, no, things na especially for the one of the problems of the barangay is the child abuse, no. So it's very important for the barangay council to come together and learn more on how to prevent, on how to help our children in our own barangay. So it's a very good dialogue also that we can share all our expertise how to protect our children in our own community.
At damdamin, takot tayo sa Panginoon. Kasi ang tao kumakapit laging sa Diyos, siguradong ang kabayaran sa Kanya, lalong mas maganda.
The seminar on religions for peace is actually conceived on the idea that in our school where students have different faith, different celebrations of their beliefs, it is a good project, but our school intended to build a common dialogue, no, inspired by the movement of the Silsilah. We begin with little acts, yet from that little acts we hope to build a longer and lasting impression.
Kasi yung tulong atong National High School kasi or the barangay itself, okay, so ito naging tapunan, or I mean yung displaced, yung mga displaced person during the siege, so iba-iba yung kanilang background, okay, so based sa experience ko rin as a teacher, since bago pa rin ako dito sa school na to, we decided na makipag-keep in touch sa Silsilah, then nag-isip kami na ganito ang dapat gawin para ma-unite namin yung aming mga estudyante, and of course with the faculty also.
Everyone deserves to be loved and to be respected, and even though we have different religion in the world, we are embracing to have faith in God, because we all know we have only one God.
World Interfaith Harmony Week at UNI-HP-Z High School.
The peace of the heart is the heart of peace. So it must come from within us.
World Interfaith Harmony seeks for goodness, for a good relationship.
So what I believe is that the mercy of God is uniform to everyone. Even though we are Muslims, if we oppress each other, the mercy of God can extend to the Christians.
Actually, today is the first part of our commemorative activity in relation to the World Interfaith Harmony Week. We started with a symposia on the importance of interfaith in campus, which we believe that when our students will be very strong in their faith, then we will be able to have a better student life while they are here. And of course, this is also in support of the global need of promoting and of course propagating the idea that faith in every individual matters so much in peace for global situation. So hopefully that this will be sustained not only for now, but for our students to be able to inculcate in their own life that their faith really matters so much.
Ang pagmamahal ng Diyos sa atin, hindi lang para sa isa, para sa lahat. Yung feeling ko na ngayon mangyayari na igagather ko ang Muslim, Christian, at iba-ibang religion para makinig. Kailangan lang may dialogue na mag-usap heart to heart para may peace po tayo. Magpapasalamat talaga ako dahil sa celebration nito, ginather ko sila lahat.
Yan, gather kami akiara, iel mga testimony ke Chene yadale grande gayot ayuda konel mga residensya aki na South Com Village.
grupo ng prayer that God has made here to be put into practice and shared to others.
Healthy people can easily be formed to become highly motivated, productive, and disciplined citizens.
Foremost, we would like to thank the Silsilah Dialogue Movement for extending the invitation to the Department of Labor and Employment. The staff that we sent to attend the farm and pharmacy expressed that she had learned a lot from the session. She is actually handling our family welfare program. So she was able to, and in the future, she would be able to share those insights and experiences and learnings from the session. As educators, we will be able to share the insights that we've learned in this activity, and we can share it to our colleagues and then even to our students, especially in our school.
The importance of this event is that it serves a way to share or to connect with us, the participants, how blessed we are here in Mindanao, despite of some violences that is happening right now. And that is one of the dialogue's objectives, sharing positivity with other people and trying to answer issues that are relevant today.
Give strength to all of us in this journey. There should always be harmony in these four pillars of dialogue that we believe we consider the spirituality of the movement. And
you see a child, you see two eyes, tama? Yes. You see a nose, you see a face, but do not judge right away.
The UNI-HP-Z National High School is joining the United Nations Interfaith Harmony Partners of Zamboanga.
I think the activity that we have today is so relevant and responsive to the needs of our students right now. The anti-bullying symposium that we have. Actually, Sinunog National High School invited me to be the resource speaker just to enlighten our students as to how do we deal with the campaign on anti-bullying. It's prevalent, it's a growing issue, it's an emerging issue, it's a problem already of our society, and most of which our students really is affected. Even our own members of our family are in our environment. In connection with our celebration of our Interfaith Harmony Week, and dialogue comes in because the concept of dialogue is really very important, especially in trying to connect and understand what life again means. Our students right now needs dialogue, and at the same time, bullying needs to be addressed through dialogue. And I see this very, it's a beautiful opportunity for our kids to also know and understand what life really means.
As you all know, the anchor of the World Interfaith Harmony Week celebration is based on the Common Work Initiatives, which is the love of God, love of neighbor, and love of the good. So this afternoon sa event, the seminar workshop on promoting peace through social media is one way to make the common words a reality. It is actually targeting the youth, the out-of-school youth learners, who are in Zamboanga
and other youth organizations because we want to expand our reach in terms of promoting peace through social media. Why are we targeting the youth? Because social media has become a socializing agent for all our youth at present. It is best to have them educate, to have them be informed, to make them aware that social media can be a tool to promote and spread the word of peace and love and harmony rather than the other. We have the training, the workshops that is going on right now is to teach the youth how to make use of social media to promote non-violence, to promote harmony, and to promote peace, which are actually the purposes and objectives or the focus of the foci of the World Interfaith Harmony Week celebration.
Today we are here at the psychiatric ward of the Zamboanga City Medical Center, and then parents from the Silsilah Elementary School is with us also to share food in solidarity with the patients in this ward. So this is an opportunity for us to be with the less privileged persons like those patients in this ward. We are happy to be here and to serve food for them.
Today, we would like to thank the Silsilah Group for coming here over the psychiatry ward of Zamboanga City Medical Center. The staff, the doctors, the consultants would like to extend their gratitude for this event. We would like to express our sincere gratitude for this. It's a very important event, not only to us, but also to our patients who are usually here lang, hindi po sila nabibisita with their families. And this event would actually uphold their feelings of being belonged in a community, in a family. And we thank you for giving things like their food, the things that they are having right now, because at one point or the other, these things are also helpful to them, the feeling of togetherness with the other people. So this is something that would break the stigma on the mental health problems we have in the country. And we are urging everyone to visit us and to do the same and see our patients who are actually stable now and would want to feel the care and the concern from other citizens. So thank you so much, Silsilah, for coming over and for continuing your works for generosity and service to others.
Although Silsilah is the one who started the initiative, we are spreading this around the world inviting all to be part of this initiative. It's an invitation for dialogue and peace.
Purify my mind to understand peace. Purify my heart to love peace. Purify my memory to work for peace. The peace that comes from your love and compassion.
This is actually the one of the activity of the World Interfaith Harmony Week, and the inmates of Zamboanga City Jail, male and female, were given the slot for this, in which February 6 was the slot given to them. Now the purpose of this activity is to also enrich their mind and there's an understanding of the importance of dialogue, no? Dialogue in promoting for peace. So in the poster, They are going to visualize the four parts of the harmony prayer, in which put it into drawing, and then to introduce the theme of today's World Interfaith Harmony Week celebration.
we will be talking about harmonizing the tribe people in the community.
Now, this youth of different religions, and this emphasizes that we can live in harmony no matter what religion we belong. According to Martin Luther King, who is also a great peacemaker, once said that intelligence plus character is the true goal of education. Hoping that this youth will not only be developed intellectually, but far more importantly is their character, their attitude, that they can live in harmony and peace no matter what religion they belong, and they are a good instrument for this world to be a better place to live for our next generation.
This event was successful because there was a cooperation of the organizers and the different young people who takes care of the different committees, as well as the participation of the different schools. So it is our pleasure. We would like to thank everyone for the success of this event.
As written in the book of God,